In last video, we looked at bidirectional RNN. Today we are going to talk about how you can convert words into numbers. When you're dealing with any natural language processing task, your input is text and machine learning models can't understand text. So you have to get it converted into a number. Let's take the example for the game of cricket. Let's say you're building an NLP model for this game and the task you have in hand is to recognize entities in a given sentence. For example, here, Dhoni would be a player name, India would be a team name, and World Cup would be a tournament. Similarly, you can have a different statement and you want to identify the entities. So this is called name entity recognition. And based on previous video, you can build an RNN that looks like this. But if you observe carefully, there was one big problem when I covered NLP task for RNN in my last video. And the problem is the input. The machine cannot understand text. See, here the input is Dhoni, Goa, Team India, whatever. The machine learning model can't understand text. We have to convert that into a number. So how do you do that? So you see, you have a text. You have to put this extra layer as an input. And you have to convert all these words to numbers. Now let's say, for training the model, you scrap the internet, okay? So you go to websites like ESPN, Crickinfo, Wikipedia, and so on. You try to grab all the articles, you know, to build your language model. And you build a vocabulary out of it. So vocabulary is nothing but list of words. So let's say this is your vocabulary. You know, you start with Aksar is the name of the player, Dhoni is the name of the player, Zimbabwe is the name of the team, and so on. Let's say my vocabulary has 50,000 words. You can assign unique number to each of these words and then you can use those numbers as an input to your RNN. For example, Dhoni has number 7, so see, use 7 here. Now, that's your option number 1, basically, converting words into unique numbers based on your vocabulary. But there are issues such as the numbers are random. They don't capture the relationship between two words. For example, in this particular case, Dhoni's number is 7, Akshar's number is 2. Dhoni and Akshar both are players, so maybe these numbers should be similar, but they are far apart. Whereas Ashes is the name of the tournament, it is more near to Akshar. So these kind of random numberings cannot capture the similarities between the words. So then the second option you have is one hot encoding. If you've seen my machine learning videos, you might have seen one hot encoding tutorial, which is basically you take all your words and when it is ashes, for ashes you put 1, remaining words you put 0 and you get a vector. For example, the vector for Akshar would be 0, 1, 1. So wherever Akshar appears, you put 1, remaining numbers are 0. So this is a very popular approach in machine learning. But this also have a couple of issues. Like number one issue is, obviously, they don't capture the relationship because see, again, there is no relationship established. You know, if I don't tell you the words, if you're just looking at these numbers, you can't tell if two words are same, you know, like banana and grapes, for example, these are the two fruits. So if you have these two fruits, maybe you want their vectors to be a little similar. The second problem is it is computationally inefficient. If your vocabulary has 50,000 words, for each word, you get a vector whose size is 50,000. Often, in machine learning problems, the number of words could be in millions or trillions. Millions or billions, not maybe not trillion, or it could be trillion in future. But you get the point. So the computational cost is very, very high. So the third option you have is using word embeddings. Word embeddings allow you to capture relationship between the two words. Let's see, how do you capture similarities between two words? So let's take the example. In order to explain how word embedding work, I want to take you back to your first machine learning problem, which is predicting home prices. So if you have two homes and you want to, let's say, figure out if these homes are similar or not, how can you do that? Well, you look at the features of the home. What are the features? It's simple, right? Like the bedrooms, area, bathrooms, and so on. So if you look at these two homes, the bedrooms are same, area is almost same, you know, 1700 versus 1850. Bathrooms are also kind of near to each other. So then we can say that these two homes are similar based on the features. If I have a third home, let's say big mansion, you know, which is very big home. And if I look at the features of this home, you know, the feature vector would be 10, 7500 and 2. And when I compare this vector with this vector, I will obviously figure out that these two homes are not similar. Can we apply similar concepts to the words? Let's say these are my words, Dhoni, Cummins. I put just pictures for the reference. Otherwise, we are comparing just the words, okay? So Dhoni, Cummins, who is an Australian player, and Australia, which is the name of the country. How can you compare these three words? Now, as a human, we know that Dhoni and Cummins are similar because these are players, you know, names of players. But Australia is not similar because it's the name of the country or name of the team. So then just think about, is there a way to retrieve features from these words? If you think hard, you might be able to come up with some features such as person, whether the person is healthy or fit, location, has two eyes, has two government, has government. So in the case of Dhoni, yeah, he's a person, healthy, fit, yeah, he's pretty healthy, but you know, maybe 0.9, we can put some number, 1 means like perfect, 0.9 is like really healthy. Is Dhoni a location? Well, no, so zero. Does he have two eyes? Now, in order to qualify for the, you know, international cricket, you need to have two eyes. So that's why so there could be many features. I just handcrafted these features. There could be 10 features here, you know, how fast he can run, whatever. Then has government. Does Dhoni have government? No, that sounds weird actually. So then I put zero. And when I put similar numbers for Cummins, I will probably get similar kind of vector. You know, here I had 1.9010, 1.87010, kind of similar vector. And I put these numbers randomly, okay? So there's no logic to it. So don't tell me like, don't ask me how the number for Cummins is 0.87 here. But for Australia, when you put the same number, Australia is not a person, so of course zero. But Australia is a location, so it's one. Australia has government, so it's one. And if you have any other countries, they will match the feature vector that I have presented here. So essentially what we did is we converted word into a vector. Vector is just a bunch of numbers, right? And when I converted that, what I found is Dhoni and Cummins are kind of similar. See, 11.9.87. But Cummins and Australia are not similar. Or Dhoni and Australia are not similar. Because see, 10.9.7, yeah, of course, 0.9.7, why 0.9? Oh yeah, maybe healthy and fit meaning for a country is, if the country is healthy economically, Australia is doing pretty good, so we can say 0.7, yeah. So some of the numbers might match, but the entire vector, if you compare the similarity, it is not very similar. So now we found this feature vector for the words, and that could be very effective to solve a variety of problems in NLP task. And this is basically word embedding. So if I look at our original vocabulary, maybe you can come up with this kind of feature vector, you know, where you can say, okay, my features are person, country, health and fit, event, gear. And when you have words like bat, well, it's gear, so it's one. Is it healthy and fit? You know, like when you train machine learning model, you might come up with these random numbers. So, but overall, you get an idea that if it is Australia country, then 0.97. One means it's perfect. 0.97, yes, it's like country. So again, I'm not putting one here, but showing 0.97 as an example, because these features, by the way, are not handcrafted. Here I handcrafted this feature, but we will be using machine learning model later to come up with these features, and you wouldn't even know what these features are, and it will just magically work. We'll cover more that of that in future. But for now, just assume there is some magical way of retrieving features from the words when you process a large corpus of text data using machine learning. So using machine learning, you can derive this kind of feature vector, okay? And once you have that, of course, when you look at the features for Cummins versus Dhoni, they're matching. So you know that these two are players. And when you look at feature vectors for Australia and Zimbabwe, they're also kind of matching. So you also know that these two are countries or team names. So you use machine learning to convert words into this kind of vectors, and those vectors are fed again into RNN, okay? And then we solve variety of problems like the sentiment classification or name entity recognition, so on, variety of NLP tasks. So just to summarize, we looked at three methods of converting words into numbers. One was unique numbers, second was one hot encoding, third was word embeddings. And in word embeddings, there are variety of techniques available such as TF-IDF and Word2Vec. Now Word2Vec, etc. will be covering in future videos. I hope you like this tutorial. If you have any question, please post your question in our comment below. Thank you.